Hey yo guys, what's up and welcome back to Two Toe Tags Metal Reviews. Today we're getting our final review of the self-titled album from Lamb of God. Okay, we spent an entire week listening to this album on full rotation non-stop, and I gotta say that I was pretty impressed by the album. There was a lot of stuff that I was like, you know, it was jumping out at me, and I was like, this is fucking cool, this is rad, this is exactly what I want from Lamb of God. I took a little stroll down memory lane, and I listened to most of their discography just to compare. Not that I'm unfamiliar with it, I've been listening to Lamb of God for a long time, I'm familiar with all their stuff. But just to get a sense of kind of where they're at now in their career versus where they've been. And I feel this fits right in the pocket of prime Lamb of God. For me personally, Ashes of the Wake is pinnacle Lamb of God. I know a lot of people feel that way. It's their most popular album, for good reason. And I feel like this self-titled album could be a direct descendant of that, sound-wise. But I hear elements from other things. I hear elements from stuff slightly older than that and stuff in between. It just feels like Lamb of God. Like, even with the absence of Chris Adler, doesn't matter. Art Cruz does a phenomenal job. Does everything he needs to do, and then some, I would say.
Honestly, it's really impressive for Art Cruz to show up that much on his first album with the band.
Yeah. Like, you can tell, like, Art Cruz knows every Lamb of God song by heart, and he can play them flawlessly, so he knows the style. He's got the style down, but he still adds his own... I don't even want to say he adds his own flair, because it just still sounds like Lamb of God. It's not like it's Lamb of God plus something else.
Yeah.
But he just fits so perfectly. There's no real criticism at all I can give to the drums for him being a new drummer in the band. He fits so well. He gels as a fine member of the band, and yeah, no complaints there whatsoever. Let me talk about a couple songs that stood out to me. First impressions, we mentioned the song Roots, which with Chuck Billy. That song consistently stayed one of my top songs throughout the week. I like Chuck's part in that song. It's subtle, but it does enough to keep this, make the song sound a little different. There was one part when I was listening to, I think it's either the second or third verse, I was like, is that Randy singing or something? That's Chuck singing a harsh vocal. I think it's Randy, but it threw me off a bit because it was slightly different vocal style that I wasn't really used to from Randy. But then if you go back through the discography like I did, you hear different vocal styles from Randy over the years in different songs. Like, if you listen to the Wraith album, is it Wraith or Wrath?
Wrath.
Wrath. He sounds a little different on that album. Or if you go way back and you listen to songs like, Terror and Hubris and the House of Pollard, Rob Pollard, Mark Pollard. Something like that.
That's from New American Gospel.
Something from New American Gospel. There's a couple songs on there where he sounds a little different on the vocals as well. So I kind of felt like I was getting something like that from this song. And I thought maybe that's Chuck Billy, or maybe it's just Randy doing a slightly different voice.
I think there is some layering on that.
There's definitely layering. They definitely harmonize through the choruses and also during the bridge. Chuck Billy, that's when he's more prominent. One of the verses sounded a little off to me. I think it still is Randy, but I was a little bit questioning it. Anyways. The song that jumped out at me the most and became my favorite song is Reality Bath. That song is fucking sick. The way it starts with this, like, just a guitar, but it's playing this really cool kind of, I don't know, I like the word ominous, so I'm gonna say ominous riff. It might not be exactly the right word I'm looking for, but it's kind of an eerie, kind of like, ooh, what's coming kind of thing.
You know, one thing I'm kind of noticing, and I guess it's a this band thing with some of their guitar riffs, is they're very bluesy sounding at times.
Oh yeah. Well, that's where the groove metal element comes yeah. in with this band. Definitely very bluesy.
You can hear that in this album.
You hear it, yeah, oh yeah, for sure. And Reality Bath is just such a sick song. Like in the second verse when he turns on that double bass, it just kind of goes, hits a switch and then it starts pounding. I love that. That's one of my favorite things that can happen in metal is when drummers just go kick and just turn it on and start going. The bridge is really awesome. The outro is really cool. I have a note here from my first impression saying there was no payoff at the end. I disagree with that. I disagree with myself. I feel like the song in itself is a big payoff because it just hits so hard. Resurrection Man is another one that hit hard for me. And On the Hook, the last song, also hit hard for me. But all in all, the album was pretty damn enjoyable.
Yeah, I have similar feelings to you. Honestly, this album is great from start to finish. And I did a lot of thinking of what makes this, you know, this album is great, but what makes it a great Lamb of God album? And I looked back through a few things. Funny you listened to the really old stuff, because I listened to the more recent stuff. I listened to the last two albums and tried to find what makes this stand out from those. And I feel like the last two albums are a little bit more adventurous for Lamb of God, a little bit. It still sounds like Lamb of God. It's not like they, you know, lost anything. It's just this one, with the riffing style and the way the songs kind of play out, it feels more attuned with older Lamb of God than the last two albums.
I'd say middle of the pack Lamb of God, like not quite the old stuff.
I'm saying like, it's comparable to like sounding like Ashes of the Wake and Sacrament. That's what I think.
I agree with that. Yeah, like middle of the pack Lamb of God is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, I can say something really great about every song in this album. Even though there are songs I enjoyed more than others, I don't think there's a single song in this album that I could call bad. I could say, that song. I could just put the whole album on and enjoy the entire thing.
Yeah, you're not gonna skip any songs.
Yeah, like Roots, whatever, is not my favorite song. You know, one of the lesser ones, but there's still good things I can say about that song. One subtle thing about that song is that near the end, you hear like big drums playing, kind of like the auxiliary drums you'd hear in Slipknot. You hear that in the background, and I noticed that after a few listens and said, wow, that's a cool, unique thing that song has, aside from the Chuck Billy feature.
There's also a drum intro on that song as well, which is, it reminded me a lot of The Wolf Is Loose from Mastodon.
I could see that.
Stylistically, the way it went.
Yeah. So that was cool. I talked a little bit-ish about the Jamie Josta feature. Saying that it was kind of, you know, not the best, and I listened to it again. I'm like, you know what? This is a really cool feature.
Like, you know what? I'm gonna counter you on that and say that probably became my least favorite part of the album. Not that I don't like it; it's fine, but it just every time it came on, I was like, get over with it already. Like, it just it kind of just slow it breaks the song up a little too much. The pace is too slow. It's just too simplistic sounding. I don't know. It wasn't doing it for me.
It's not the best Jamie Josta feature I've heard on a song.
No.
But when his voice kicks in, it just feels great.
Yeah.
It makes you want to just fucking punch bricks. But that's what his voice does. You want to take a house down.
Like I said before, he's doing it. Jamie Josta's doing what Jamie Josta does. And I don't know. For me, it sounded amazing at first. I was really digging it. But the more I heard it, the more I was like, eh. And I also kind of feel the same with the bit with the intro to the album, Memento Mori. Remember we talked about it?
Yeah.
And you said it's going to get old and stale. And I said, no, don't worry about it. It's gonna feel like nothing after a few listens. I completely agree with TV Fish. I wish this intro was much shorter. They go four bars. Or if they come in on the fourth bar, I wish they came in on the third bar. That would be perfect for me. But they go that whole extra bar, and I'm like, God, it just sounds so draggy.
They do a full 16 bars of an intro, and it's kind of slow, and it's 2 minutes. And that song is phenomenal. That's one of my favorites still on the album. Love that song. The only thing I don't like is that intro. I kind of got used to it, but I still kept thinking to myself when I'm listening to the song, I'm like, if only this intro was shorter. I want to get to the action, because the action is insane.
Yeah.
Another song that really, really jumped out at me was Resurrection Man. This song sounds so evil,
mean,
brooding, mean, dark. It's slower paced than other songs, and that's really cool.
Yeah.
And some aspects of it, maybe like the chorus, kind of reminded me of Omerta a little bit.
I got a little bit of Remorses for the Dead vibes from that song. Just the slowness of it, that slow brooding kind of.
That works too. It's not as fast as Omerta, but
no.
I don't know. The chorus kind of reminded me a little bit.
Yeah.
But the fucking breakdown at the end of that song is disgusting.
Slams.
And what's really cool is I don't think they're doing this, but the guitars almost sound like, you know, you have the drums playing in duple meter, and it sounds like the guitars are doing like a quarter note triplet. They're not. At least I don't think they are, but it almost sounds like they're doing a three against, you know, four of the drums.
I wouldn't doubt it.
It's possible.
I wouldn't doubt it.
It's just so subtle, though. It's like, I listen to it, I'm like, are they doing that? It kind of sounds like it, but I don't think that's what they're actually doing. I think that's just an effect of what you're hearing, which is really cool that there's, like, quote-unquote, like, false depth, I guess. Like, is it the case? Is it not? I don't know. It's a cool thing.
There is some pretty cool guitar work on this album. Like, Lamb of God's known for being, like, basically, like, riff monsters. Like, these guys know the way around the guitar. You'll take a song like On the Hook, for example. During the bridge, there's this part where
There's like a chuggy rhythm guitar, and then there's this ominous lead going over top of it, just contrasting each other, but it creates this cool atmospheric, you know, element to the song. And then you have another thing, which I noticed, which was in Reality Bath and Resurrection Man, both of these songs have this siren-esque riff to them, which is something that is common on past Lamb of God work. It's this weird, like, I just can only describe it as a siren, but they play around with it. They don't do the exact same each time. So it's just, I don't know, it's a really cool effect that they like to do.
I think there's a song that uses an actual siren sample. I don't remember which one, but there was one that literally has a siren in it.
You might be thinking of Reality Bath.
It might be Reality Bath.
I still think that's guitar. I don't think it's a, I don't think there's a sample, but.
Maybe it is a guitar.
Yeah.
Another song I really liked was New Colossal Hate, which is one of the singles. I think the last single they released before the album came out. And I just love the chorus of that song. It just feels so just fucking hard. Like, every song in this album is hard, and it's great, and it's a solid fucking album.
All right, let's rate the album. PB Fish, what do you give it?
All right, I think it's pretty obvious that this album gets my toe tag. It's straight up a good album. Fans of Lamb of God will like it. Non-fans can get into this band from it. Like, it's just overall such a strong album. Every song's good. I've noticed it's a bit divisive of the fan base saying, oh, it's just same old Lamb of God. But honestly, the more you listen to this album, the more it's going to jump out to you. Awesome album.
Yeah, you know what? I consider Lamb of God in the upper echelon of metal bands. Okay, this is the kind of band that'll headline festivals with 50 other bands underneath them. So with a band like that, you kind of got a higher standard for their music, right? So when I was rating this album, I tried to take my memory out and make it so, like, this is the first Lamb of God album I'm ever hearing. Try to erase everything I've known about them. And how do I feel about this album if this is my introduction to Lamb of God? And I gotta say, it hit all the right marks. It checked all the right boxes. This album gets my toe tag as well. Very, very deserving. I really can't say anything bad about it. If your worst criticism is that this sounds too much like old Lamb of God, that's not a criticism in a bad way. That's a compliment, because old Lamb of God is fucking good too. So I think well deserved. This album gets two toe tags. I'm not surprised at that score at all. But yeah, that's it for this review, guys. So if you like this album, let us know in the comments below if you agree with our scores or not. Like this video if you liked it. Subscribe if you guys are new to the channel. Make sure you guys are coming back every single day to vote on our Best Metal Band in the World tournament. That's it from us for now. I'm Vile Self.
I'm TV Fish.
We'll see you guys in the next video. Keep those heads banging.